Hey guys, welcome to NextGenTech, and in this video we are going to unboxing and reviewing the Samsung M5 Smart Monitor. This is not a gaming monitor at all, but a multi-purpose monitor. It comes in three different screen sizes, a 24-inch, a 27-inch and a 32-inch. Before starting, I want to thank Clarion Computers for providing us with this monitor for reviewing. If you guys are looking for any computer hardware and peripherals, then you can visit their store, which is located at Kolkata. From PC cabinets, motherboards, CPUs, graphics card, you will find everything there at great prices. And if you're not from Kolkata, then you can visit their website, which is www.clariancomputers.in, and place your order online. I will put the website link and the store location in the video description. So let's get started. Out of the box, we get the power adapter and a cable, one HDMI cable, and the best part of the monitor is it comes with a remote, which is provided with two AAA batteries, stand, base, and finally the monitor itself. Coming to the installation and setup, the monitor is very simple and easy to install. You can do both the table and the wall mount. For the table mount, first fit the stand with the screws in it with the provided two screws. Then take the base and screw it into the stand, and that's it. You are done installing the monitor. Now we power it on, then it will pop up the first time setup as the monitor comes with the dedicated Tizen OS. So we go through that setup quickly. Select your language first, then you'll ask for connecting to the Wi-Fi, and yes, this monitor comes with a dedicated Wi-Fi connectivity as well. Just like in any other smart TVs. Next, it will ask for accepting in terms and conditions. If you want to, you can create a Samsung account, or you just have an option to skip it, and that's all. Your monitor is set up. Coming to the physical overview, at the front we see the 24-inch display. It has a minimal bezel on all the sides and the Samsung logo at the center bottom. Coming to the rear side, we found the wall mount screw holes, a USB port, two HDMI 2.0 ports, power and a Kensington security slot. At the back, the stand also has a hook to secure all your cables and hide them from the view. And finally, there's the Samsung logo. Thickness of the monitor is 1.6 inch without the stand, and the monitor weighs around 2.9 kgs with the stand. There is a button at the bottom which is used to open the monitor settings, where you can get the power off, volume and the source. And also there is an infrared sensor right beside it. Finally, there are two speakers on bottom left and right, and the sound from the speaker is not that loud but not that low, but gets the job done. And for the stand, it is tiltable, but you can't change the monitor orientation and adjust it sideways. Talking about the operating system, this isn't an Android system, but instead it comes with Samsung's own Tizen OS built into it. You will find Netflix, Prime Video, Z5, Apple TV, YouTube pre-installed. You will find many shows and series below the home screen for you to watch. You can also access the Netflix, Prime Videos and browser with the press of a button from the remote. Talking of the browser experience is pretty smooth. There is also a cursor in which you can use it by controlling with the directional keys from the remote. And also you can connect a wireless mouse to the monitor and bang. You can use the mouse to control anything you want in the Tizen OS. You can also do the same thing with a wireless keyboard, but the drawback is that there is only one USB port on the monitor. Coming to the monitor specs, this monitor comes with an IPS panel with 1920x1080 resolution with 60Hz refresh rate, max brightness of 250 nits and having HDR10 support. As I said earlier, this monitor is not for gaming at all because of the 14ms response time, which is on the slower side. But you can still use it for casual gaming, which we'll do it later in this video. The IPS technologies in this monitor is very low, but still a major upgrade over the VA panel. Starting with the pixel density, the PPI is moderate for a 24-inch Full HD display. Viewing angles are passable if you don't care about the colors, as there are noticeable color change when you shift angles. Green color is not accurate at all. The reds and blue are very vibrant, deep black with high contrast. Overall, the panel has a higher color temperature, yellowish panel, and the tint greenish panel, which means that it's more on a yellower and a greener side. It also has a poor dynamic range performance, meaning a lower number of shades of blacks and a gray can be displayed. Let's have a quick look with all the settings this monitor comes packed with. There's a picture mode, speaker settings, game mode, ultra wide game mode, we will be looking after this when you try to play games, and eye saver mode, sleep timer, network settings, and into the main settings, which have more advanced options for adjusting brightness, contrast, sharpness, colors, and much more. One thing I will mention that the most of these advanced settings can only be adjusted only when you are using this monitor as a TV. That is when you are using it in a Tizen OS, not on a HDMI input source. Along with this monitor, an infrared remote control has been provided. You can find different buttons on it to open Netflix, Prime Videos or the web browser. Also the volume up down, switch channel, home, back, play and pause button, a directional round keypad, a power button. The remote uses a pair of AAA batteries. The good thing is that Samsung has provided a pair of out of the box, so you can get started right away. Talking about the connectivity and unique features, there is a lot of unique features this monitor has. If you have a Samsung smartphone, you can use it to run the Samsung DeX, which is a full-fledged desktop running through your smartphone's hardware. There is also an Apple AirPlay port using to mirror your iPhone to the monitor. Then for the Windows PC, there is an option for screen sharing and proper remote desktop connection support. Yes, you don't need any hardware on your side to use the remote desktop, just a monitor and a wireless keyboard mouse, and that's all you need. For Mac users, AirPlay and remote PCs are also supported. Some games on this monitor with game mode on and off, but we didn't find any difference between the two options. Also, we tried the ultra-wide game view option, but we still didn't do anything. If you play FPS game which requires quick movement, there is a noticeable ghosting due to the 14ms response time. If you don't know what the response time is, there is a picture for you to understand. For casual gaming, it should be not a problem, but in reality, this monitor is not for gaming. So all I can say, it's quite an interesting monitor from Samsung, which supports both your work purpose and your entertainment purpose. It has a great number of features, all thanks to the Tizen OS, which is installed in this monitor. But I won't recommend this monitor for playing games, because this is not at all a gaming monitor. It's of totally a work purpose and an entertainment system. So if you want a gaming monitor, there is different kind of monitors in the market available. You can check them out, but I won't recommend this monitor for gaming purpose itself. So that's it for today's video. If you like this video, don't forget to like and subscribe to our channel. If you have any questions, feel free to comment down below, and you can also follow our social handles listed over here. And thanks for watching Next Gen Tech.